Yes, yes, y'all. Welcome to another episode of Lab Work. It's your boy, Coach T. I hope everyone is staying safe and doing as well as they can be doing in this state of civil unrest and COVID-19. 2020 has been one for the ages, boy, I tell you. It really has. But I'm basically here posting this video to my young ballers out there, man, especially my young Black and Brown brothers. Like, I feel like it's the perfect time to basically speak on this topic, right? They always say that we could use sports to help unite and bring people together, or unity, you know, peace, and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But I'm going to talk to you how we can start using sports to help and betterment our people as a whole, right? We got to start really using basketball as a tool and not stop letting it use us. We need to start getting more out of it than they get out of us, right? Example. Everybody's not going to the pros. Everybody's not going overseas. Everybody's not going D1. And that's just the reality of it. You know what I'm saying? That's just the reality of it. Excuse me. That's the reality of it. So we got to figure out now, at a certain point, as far as by the time you get to college, you know, your second year in college, you pretty much know. Your first year in college, you pretty much know whether you're going, you know what I mean? You know whether you going to the pros overseas, you have an idea, you know what I mean? And if you don't, then you need to start thinking about it at that time when you get to that point. And us as parents, coaches, and mentors, we got to do a better job instilling this in our youth as well. Using basketball as a tool to betterment themselves, their family, and their people, even if they're not making it to the pros, right? Or overseas, right? And look how this works. Go to high school, finish high school, you get a scholarship to go to a school, whether it's Division I or two or three, right? Like I said, at a certain point, you know whether you're going overseas or not. We get caught up nowadays, our athletes, we caught up in this one and done or 2 years of going to the pros to try to get the bag. Granted, I get it, I understand it, right? But a lot of y'all are not being realistic with yourselves, right? We not, and we got to start really having them conversations with ourselves and asking ourselves, is this really what we want to do? And if it's actually achievable, and then how could it's gonna, and is it gonna really help you in the long run, right? I feel like a lot of us is not going to school. We're not finishing getting these 4-year degrees. Like I said, everybody's not one and done. Everybody's not two and done. You got to start being real with yourself. How can you help your family in the wrong one? And you know how you can't do that? You go to these schools, right? You pay nothing. You get these 4-year degree, 4-year scholarships, right, to these schools, right? If you're not a one and done kid, you know you're not going lottery or whatever the case may be. You get your degree, right? You get your 4-year degree. Right? And then from there, you get your 4-year degree, whether you go overseas or not. You got your degree, right? You have no debt. Zero debt. Zero debt. I don't think you guys understand what that means. You have zero debt, meaning you owe no loans coming out of college, right? So it's important while you're in school, you get a major that you really actually enjoy and see yourself doing in the long run. If you want to still keep it in sports world, then you could do sports management, physical therapy, business management. I can go on and on. Focus on that field of, you know what I mean? Other side of basketball, the other side of the sports world, or it could be something different. You want to be a teacher, a doctor, whatever it is, right? The point is, you don't have no debt coming out of school, and that's what hinders most of us Black folk. And especially the more degrees we get, the more loans we taking out, you know what I'm saying? Put us in major debt. So back to like I was saying, we go to school, you get your degree, right? Whether you decide to go to seas, whether you decide to play overseas or try to go to NBA or not, get that degree, right? You get that degree, you have no debt, right? You come out of school, get you a good job. I mean, based on whatever the field is, based on whatever field it is that you studied, or maybe not. But you got your degree, so your degree guarantees you a certain amount of income out of college when you're getting this job, right? Again, now you're out of college, you have no debt, zero debt, right? Because why? You use basketball as a tool to provide you a free education so that when you graduate, you have zero debt, right? You get your first job. Let's say your studies was in something like, let's just say physical therapy, right? So let's say it's physical therapy, right? You're coming out of college, right? Physical therapist, you know what I mean? Making 80 to 100K, right? 5 years after you coming out of college, you can now buy a home, right? 15 years after that, 10 to 15 years after that, you own that home, right? Now you have ownership, right? That's how you create the generational wealth, right? Because now you own this, you have property, you can pass this down from generations. Right? Come out of school, own homes, own businesses, start building in your communities, right? Things of that nature. Because everybody's not going to the pros, right? Everybody's not going to happen. So we got to start doing a better job preparing our youth and our athletes, our ballers, to use the sports and not let it use them. Get these degrees, because this is important. Zero debt out of college is why most of the other folks of, you know what I mean, other races have that wealth. Besides other things that play that come into factor, but the main thing is that they have no debt coming out of college. We always have massive, massive debt coming out of college. You know what I mean? We and our quick fix is we're going to go and get another degree and we just get more in debt. So I'm just posting this to say we got to start instilling in our youth, right? Use the sport. It's a tool. Get your degree. Like I said, you got them. You got the, you know, you got the those players that's definitely one and done, definitely going to go to the pros, definitely going to go overseas, right? But the numbers are few and far in between, right? So you got to figure it out. Have fun right now along the way. Work as hard as you can so that way you can be that. You can be that pro. But like I said, there's one out of the number. One out of every how many? 100 might make it. I think the number's even slimmer than that. So we got to start preparing our youth and really stressing them to get that degree, man. Get that degree because it's free. It's free. Free, free, free. No debt. No debt out of college. Get you a good job. Within 5 years, you could get that house. Within 10 to 15 after that, it's paid for, depending on how much you're making. We got to start using this and being smart, man, using the basketball wisely, getting way more smart with it, not just shooting it. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, man, I'm out of here. Y'all stay safe, man. You already know Black Lives Matter, lab work.